When it comes to seafood, one thing we can't get enough of are prawns. In Britain, we consume about 85,000 tons of them every year. And the best thing is you can catch them all around our shores if you know where to look.
I just love the sea. I love the smell. I love when you get the wind through your hair and to be on a beach with my prawning net. You never know what you might find. We've got masses of winkles around here, and I'm hoping I'll find an odd prawn.
Today, I'm in Botany Bay, Kent, to meet local naturalist Dr. Alistair Bruce, to see if he can help me catch some of the local delicacies.
This is a marvellous stretch of coastline. What would one expect to find?
We catch prawns. There are plenty of winkles here. There's occasional wild oysters. And the rocks beside us here are often full of lobster and crab. So it's a serious smorgasbord of shellfish.
I'm definitely after prawns.
Well, there's a good chance.
There's a good chance. So wish me luck.
Good luck. Right underneath you with a bit of luck.
Prawns can be found all around the British coast. They live in areas where they have rock and weed cover. If you want to catch them, try a low tide during the summer months.
Oh, they said current. I'm doing very, 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 and then I'll catch them.
That's it.
There's not a lot of sport in there.
No. Well, you've got some edible seaweed.
Okay, I think I was a bit quick.
Nice and gently.
You have got one. I have.
Fantastic.
It's a whopper.
There you go.
No, don't. It's mine.
Okay.
That is a sheer beauty. It's all mine. I'm going to do the cooking because you're the fisherman. I didn't know what I was doing, really. And you say always cook it in seawater if you can.
Yeah. There you go. Oh,
look at those beauties.
Out. Straight in.
Look, they've gone from translucent to a pale pink. In a minute, our fisherman's tea will be ready.
Absolutely, and it's all free.
The most exciting thing of all is, of course, doing it on the beach, sitting round, and we'll have such an appetite when it comes. Pity we didn't catch twice as many prawns. Well, nothing could be fresher, could it?
A lovely colour, isn't it?
It is so exciting. Mind you, I think I can see the one I caught. It's that very big one there. It was pretty big, though, wasn't it?
It was.
You must admit.
It was. I'll give you that.
A little bit of lemon. So here goes.
There we go. All the best.
Cheers.
Oh, that is really nice.
Do you know, I'm sure it's better to cook them in that salt water. It is absolutely beautiful. It doesn't need any mayonnaise. It doesn't need anything.
No, not really. Very nice.
This, to me, is wonderful. It's a treasure from the sea.
The beauty of fresh seafood is it doesn't take a moment to cook. This linguine is a luxurious dinner party dish for six that takes no time to prepare.
It's absolutely delicious and rather different. So to start with, I've taken three shallots and I've slowly cooked those and they're just nice and soft. And I've got some linguine here and it's 250 grams. Cook it as the packet says. It's usually about 10 minutes.
Add to the shallots one finely chopped red chilli and two cloves of crushed garlic.
Now I've got some beautiful fresh clams here. I've given them a good scrub. If any of these are open, you're not to put them in there because they're not fresh. Tip those in and the shock of the heat will start them to open. Then I'm going to add 250ml of wine, give or take a bit. I shouldn't say a bit of wine. You can't have a bit of wine. My husband's always telling me that. A drop of wine. Give that a bit of a stir, then in the lemon goes. Those are cooking nicely, but to make sure they all open, they need to be in the steam. So pop that on.
This should only take about 3 minutes. Once the clams are all open, add the cooked pasta.
Just leave that for the moment. It's on a very, very low heat. And I'm going to quickly get on with cooking the rest of the shellfish, and that'll just take a couple of minutes.
To make it even more luxurious, I'm also including squid and king prawns.
Keep moving them about. And you'll know when the prawns are done because they'll turn bright pink. You can see the squid is changing colour.
And for something special, add 6 scallops sliced in half to make them go further.
So there it is. Doesn't that look beautiful? Loaded with wonderful seafood. What I've forgotten to do is my tomato. I've still got the heat on here. Just shows you I'm not perfect.
Season and fry the tomato for a couple of minutes before adding to the pasta with a generous handful of chopped parsley and mix all together.
Doesn't that look good? That is, to me, sheer luxury. Everybody will feel that you've spoilt them rotten.
I love my linguine, but sometimes I feel like a more traditional fillet. And so here's a favourite recipe for the catch of the day.
Sea bass has become very popular, quite understandably, because brill and halibut and Dover sole are very expensive. It has a lovely flavour, sea bass, and when you marry it with my favourite ingredient, shrimps, in a delicious sauce, what could be better?
To make the sauce, start by frying one finely sliced onion till soft, then add 200 ml of white wine and reduce it by half.
Then in goes 300 ml of double cream, and it must be double. If you use single cream, you'll have to boil it too long and there is a chance two of it splitting.
Coat the sea bass fillets in seasoned flour and fry in oil and butter.
I cook the white side down first, particularly if I'm doing 6 fillets, because if you do the skin side first, bits come off, you get flecks, then you put the white side down on it and it doesn't look so good. So that's why I do it that way around. Now I'm just going to have a look and see how it's doing. Oh, that's a lovely colour. To get the skin really crispy, press the fish down and it will catch on the bottom.
To finish the sauce, add the juice of half a lemon, a tablespoonful of capers and a good amount of chopped parsley.
And the main ingredient, these beautiful shrimps. Do you know, I can't resist these. They are absolutely delicious. Not just one, I had about 7. So in they go. About 120 grams there. What could be better than that? To me, this sauce looks most tempting. We've got lovely shrimps, then a finely sliced onion, parsley and capers in a lovely creamy sauce. I'm going to serve it up. Oh, that looks a beautiful brown colour. Just perfect. Pop that on the plate. Now to my shrimp sauce. And lots of shrimps on the side there. That's it. I've got some piping hot beans here. Just there. I think that looks so tempting, I can't possibly not taste it. That reminds me of the sea. Takes me back to holidays.